So how would you do this integrate?
Papa Flammy's Advent Calendar.
Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. It's Advent Calendar time, and this time on the Advent Calendar, okay, Advent Calendar time, this time on the Advent Calendar, what a very nice sentence right here. We are going to deal with an integral equation. It's an initial value problem, basically. Overall, it's just a differential equation, but differential equations and integrals, they are closely related, so integrals are just special case of differential equation. Never mind, we are going to destroy this thing today. Something kind of surprising is going to pop out. But before we dive into the main video, I would like to give a huge shout out to today's sponsor, Skillshare, for sponsoring this episode of the Advent Calendar. Skillshare is basically simply an online learning community with over 23,000 courses. So it really doesn't quite matter if you want to learn something about mathematics, like what we do here, or how to carve wood, how to get good in Adobe Premiere Pro, or you want to learn something about finances. It really doesn't quite matter. Skillshare has you covered on everything. The strongest point about Skillshare is that the majority of those courses, workshops, etc. are being created by professional people who do this stuff on a daily basis. So if you want to learn something about how to edit videos, then go ahead, take a look at the beginner's guide, for example, on how to edit videos in Sony Vegas. And there you go, someone professional has you covered with a full beginner's guide on how to cut videos. So if this feels like something for you, if this sounds like something interesting, take a look at top of the description. There you will be able to get a 2 months free premium membership to Skillshare. Just use the link at the top of the description. You can support the channel this way. And now we are going to dive into the main video. So how would you deal with an integral equation like this? So at first I want you guys to notice something. Let us suppose that our function in here, x times f of x, is actually integrable, Riemann integrable. For example, it's a continuous function, okay? Let us suppose that's, for example, a continuous function, okay? It really doesn't quite matter. The only point is that it's going to be integrable. Then our function, if we integrate it, allows for a primitive, okay, an antiderivative. It's a function or an integral without upper and lower bounds, meaning it's an indefinite integral. We are going to end up with just some primitive plus c, okay? So if we integrate this, we are going to end up with some capital F of x. I'm going to put it like this. Now, what were to happen if we were to differentiate a primitive? The biggest property about a primitive is that if you differentiate it, you are going to end up with this function here. So meaning, if we differentiate both sides, we are going to end up with this function in itself, so the differential of f of x with respect to x, meaning it's just x times f of x. But also, what are we going to have here? We are going to differentiate this thing. Differentiating the constant is going to end up with here, zero. Then we are going to differentiate it. Please note that we have to use the chain rule. At first we are going to reduce the exponent by 1, okay, we are going to drag the exponent down, 2 over 2 is going to give us 1, and we are going to reduce it by 1, meaning this is simply f of x, but also we have to take the inner derivative. This is just d dx of f of x, meaning this is times d f dx. I'm going to put it like this. Also, we are going to differentiate f of x. If it's differentiable, then, well, here we go, okay, we are just going to add the differential of f to it. Now, we already came pretty far on that. If we were to write this into easier notation, okay, how you are used to it, this is going to be the same as, for example, x times y being equal to y times y prime plus y prime. I hope you can see that, yeah, we can deal with it like this. Now, let us factor out the y prime. We are going to end up with y plus 1 times y prime. Also, we are basically done solving this differential equation because we can use separation of variables. We can make this a function with respect to x only and this a function with respect to y, for example. If we divide both sides by y under the condition that our f being equal to y is not equal to 0, okay, we are going to end up with a simple differential equation. Is it nonlinear? I don't know. It's probably nonlinear. It's a nonlinear differential equation. Never mind that. I'm going to write it out yet again. We are going to end up with x being equal to y plus 1 over y times y prime, which is nothing other than, okay, we are going to break up this fraction. This is going to give us 1 plus 1 over y times y prime. We are going to integrate both sides with respect to x respectively, leaving us with the solution to our differential equation if we were to integrate both sides with respect to x. Dx and 1 over dx is going to cancel out, okay, leaving us just with a dy in the process. Then we are going to integrate this side with respect to y. It's going to give us y plus the natural log of y. And on this side, we are going to get x squared over 2 plus some arbitrary constant, I don't know, gamma, for example, or eta. I really don't care. So x squared over 2 plus eta being equal to, this is just a constant out of the real complex numbers, I don't know, y plus the natural log of y. Now, that's basically the solution to our differential equation. We could raise both sides to base e, okay, to end up with a final expression for y, kind of. Meaning, if we were to use base e on both sides, we are going to end up with e to the x squared over 2 plus eta. This is the same as e to the something times e to a constant, which is yet another constant. I'm going to call it e snug, as always. So this is e snug. Also, we are going to end up with e to the y times y. And this should ring a bell for you guys. If you want to find a solution to our differential equation y with respect to x, then we have to, we just have to separate for our y, okay? Bringing y on one side, y of x being equal to something. Now, what are we going to do about this thing right here? We're going to take a look at the Lambert W function. I've introduced it before. So if we take a look at the Lambert W function, at first we have some function f of x being equal to x times e to the x, or y times e to the y. Then it's a function of y, okay? Really doesn't quite matter. Then we can make use of the inverse function. It's called the Lambert W function. We are going to plug it in. Then we are going to end up with Lambert of y times e to the Lambert of y. But most importantly, if we use the function on the inverse function under the condition that it's invertible, we're going to end up with the argument itself. We are going to make use of Lambert W function. We are going to apply it to both sides. Meaning overall, we are going to end up with y of x being thus equal to, well, Lambert W function of this thing. Lambert W of e to the x squared over 2 times e snug. We are basically done. Only one thing is missing. We had an initial value problem. So we have to find out what our e snug actually is. Okay, this is weird. If we were to just plug our values in, we are going to end up with y of 1 being equal to 1, being equal to Lambert W of e to the 1 half times e snug. So what the hell is e snug? How are you going to solve for that? Well, we are going to take a look at something simpler. We are just going to plug our values in here. Meaning, our y is going to be 1 for the initial value problem. Our y is 1, leaving us on this side with e to the first power, being equal to x is also 1, so this is e to the 1 half power times e snug. Now we can multiply both sides by e to negative 1 half power. It's not equal to 0, okay, exponential function. It's not equal to 0. Then we are going to end up with e snug being nothing other than e to the 1 half power. Meaning we can rewrite our e snug as e to the 1 half power. Also, you can bring those together to get a Lambert W function of e to the x squared plus 1 over 2. But this is it. I think that's watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, recommend, channel, if you like, don't forget to check out Papa Flemmy's shop, 10 to 15% of everything over the course of the whole December. And well, you know what you can do to support channel. Thank you guys for watching. Up until next video, have a flammable day. Ciao.